Hello everyone, this is me Manoj, your English coach. Welcome to Love English. And in today's video, I'm gonna be reading a story called Heart of Gold. Now let's get started. This is a true story. I heard it on the radio during one of my visits to the US. It happened in one of the biggest cities in the world, New York. It was winter. One evening, a worried mother stood shivering by the road, wearing an old coat. With her was a little girl, thin, sick-looking, with a shaven head. She was wearing an oversized dress, which somebody had probably given to her out of mercy. It was apparent that they were homeless and poor. The child had a cardboard placard in her hand which said, "I'm suffering from cancer. Please help me." The mother was carrying a begging bowl. Whenever the traffic lights turned red, they would approach people, stopping them on the road and asking for help. America is a rich country, but if you are sick and don't have insurance, then you are lost. Nobody can support you. People give small amounts of money when they see such pleas for help. This kind of a scene is not uncommon in India. We see lots of beggars with small infants in one hand and a begging bowl in another. But in America, it is not so common. People felt bad for this unfortunate mother and child. One day, a policeman was passing by and saw them. He asked them a few questions and noticed that the child indeed looked very sick, with a swollen eyes and shaven head. He wanted to help, so he opened his purse. He saw a bundle of notes, which he had just drawn from the bank. He had received a good bonus for the excellent work he had done. He thought, "I have a warm home, a caring wife, and a loving son. God has been very kind to me, but these unfortunate people don't have any one of these things. It is not their mistake that God has not been kind to them." He remembered the many things he had promised his wife and son he would buy them when he got his bonus. For a while, he was in two minds. Then he decided and gave all the cash which he had withdrawn from the bank to the woman and said, "Please take good care of the child." When he reached home, his son met him at the doorstep as usual and hugged him. The house was warm and nice. He sat in front of his wife and, looking at the snow falling outside, he narrated the whole incident. After listening to him for a while, his wife was silent. Then she smiled, but the son was very angry. He said, "Dad, how are you sure that they have not cheated you? And even though you wanted to give some money, you could have given some portion. Why did you give everything?" The policeman laughed at his son and said, "Son, you do not know what poverty is. I come across such unfortunate people in my work." The days passed and everybody forgot about it. One day, a news item in the paper caught the son's attention. Mother and child caught cheating. With great interest, he read, "A greedy mother used her healthy child to pose as a cancer patient. She shaved the child's head, starved her, and dressed her shabbily so that anybody would feel the child was suffering from cancer. Using this tactic, she duped many people. The mother has been arrested." The son realized who these people were and was very upset. When his father came home, he told him as soon as he entered the house, "Dad, you were cheated by that lady and her child, who you thought was a cancer patient. The child is healthy and you gave away your entire bonus to that child." His father did not reply. He sat down and looked out of the window. There were children playing outside. Winter was over and summer was setting in. In a calm voice, he said, "Son, I'm very happy. The child is healthy." The boy was surprised. He thought, being a policeman, his father would pick up the phone and talk to the police station, or he would be depressed that he had been cheated and given away so much of money to a healthy child. But there were no traces of such emotions. He asked, "Dad, tell me, are you not upset?" His father again gave him the same answer, "I'm happy that the child is healthy." By that time, his wife came with a mug of coffee in her hand. She had heard the entire conversation. With happiness in her voice, she told her son, "Son, you are very fortunate. You have an extraordinary father who is not angry even though he has lost a lot of money. You should be proud that your father is happy thinking somebody's child is healthy. Rather than worrying about his own big bonus, learn from him. Help people without expecting anything in return."
Thank you for attending this session. Do share and subscribe to this channel for more lessons like this. Check out other video lessons by clicking on the video.